What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. I had to come on real quick and address some blowback that I got from a recent Kirk Franklin video where I addressed his rap performance in the preview to the BET Hip Hop Awards. It seems as if you all thought that I was putting words in Kirk Franklin's mouth when he said the lion and the lamb will bow down to the goat. Some of you in the comments are saying that Kirk Franklin meant that the GOAT was God, the greatest of all time, G-O-A-T. Well, that's fine if you believe that, but that's not what Kirk Franklin said. And unlike you, I'm not willing to put words in Kirk Franklin's mouth. I'm only telling you what the man said. The verse in the rap says, Biggie, Jay, and Nas, the greatest capable, the lion and the lamb will bow down to the goat. Well, first of all, I'm a West Coast cat, right? So the fact that you didn't put Pac in there, addressing hip hop saying the greatest capable, well, that's blasphemous unto itself. These are not my words. These are Kirk Franklin's words. And he said specifically in his retort on Twitter, metaphorically, I position those considered great as lions and lambs, and how they will someday bow down to Jesus, the greatest of all times. But aside from that, let's put that aside. Biggie, Jay, and Nas. In Kirk Franklin's words, he metaphorically elevated those three into the position of the lion and the lamb, where the goat would be Jesus. But hold on a second. You got Biggie, you got Jay, you got Nas, but you only got two slots to put them in, the lion and the lamb. Bruh, your math ain't mathing. Or is it just me? And what gives you the authority to take rappers who have contributed nothing but detriment to society and elevate them to the level of the lion and the lamb? Or even if we take a step back, what gives you the authority to elevate them to be the greatest capable? Tupac Shakur said, Brenda's got a baby, but Brenda's barely got a brain. A dang shame, the girl can hardly spell her name. Those lyrics from 20 years ago are still relevant today. What did Biggie say? Black and ugly as ever. However, I stay Gucci down to the socks. Rings and watch filled with rocks. And my jam knocks in your Mitsubishi. Well, bro, what have you contributed to society for someone like Kirk Franklin to even elevate you to the status of the greatest capable in hip hop? Ain't no way, boy. Ain't no way, boy. But I understand that a lot of you are new followers to the channel. We get a lot of views from people who aren't even subscribers to this channel, but new to the content. And I just ask that you listen carefully to what's being said and think critically about the subject matter. And hopefully we can all grow together. It's hyperbole, not theology. So if you're misunderstanding the words, understand, you're not misunderstanding me. You're misunderstanding Kirk Franklin, who's taken three rappers who he determines to be the greatest capable and elevating them to the status of the Lion of Judah, the Lamb of God, to bow down to the goat that he says is Jesus. But you and I both know better. We know that Jesus is the Lamb of God. Jesus is the Lion of Judah. How can Jesus be the goat and the lion and the lamb at the same time? Would he bow down to himself? Is Kirk making a circular argument? Or is Kirk trying to pull the wool over our eyes? Like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation. And like I always say, y'all, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.